So today we are going to look at few essential things that are needed while you are on stage. Few important things or few essentials are there which we need to keep in mind if we really want to enhance our communication on stage. Now, there are two parts of an effective communication on stage. When you are on stage, your communication has two effective parts. Okay, two important parts are there for effective communication. The first one is the text, the second one is delivery. What do you mean by text? Text ka matlab kya hai? Text ka matlab you should have something in your hand so that you may take it to the stage and you may deliver it. Aapke paas kuch aisa material hona chahiye jo aap apne saath mein lekar ja sake aur usko aap deliver kar sake. So two things are important. The first thing is text and the second thing is how you deliver it, how you say it in front of people. Now, the first thing that we are going to look at is a text and how we need to have a good text. The most important thing for a good text is, sabse jyada zaruri cheez jo ek acche text ke liye hona chahiye, that is a clear purpose. You should have a purpose in mind. You should have a clear purpose in mind. Probably you want them to take a decision. Probably you want them to do something. Probably you want them to begin a new life. Probably you want them to come out of depression. Probably you want them to have a happy life. Whatever it is, the main and the most important thing is you should know the purpose. Aapko wo purpose jana bahut zaruri hai ki aap kya chahte hain. Do not come on stage without a purpose in your mind. Jab tak aapke man mein purpose nahi hai aur jab tak aap purpose ke bare mein clear nahi hai, do not come on stage. Why? What is going to happen? You will come on stage, you will talk about 10 different things and you will mess up everything. Aap stage ke par aaoge, ab 10 cheezon ke bare mein baat karoge, yahan wahan har jagah mein baat karoge, and you won't be able to make the people or you won't be able to persuade a person to do something. Aap logon ko kuch karne ke liye, you won't be able to persuade them to do something. So the most important thing that you need to know is you should have a clear purpose in mind. Now, how can we get a clear purpose? Kis tarike se hum log ek clear purpose ko apne man mein rakh sakte hain? How can we have a clear purpose? The first thing is you need to get impregnated with a thought. Everything starts with a thought. Sab aapke man mein, everything starts with a seed of thought. Aapke man mein thought hota hai. It has to start with a thought. You have this thought and you work on it. Now remember, once you have a thought, you have to walk with that thought. You have to talk with the thought. You have to sleep with the thought. You have to think about the thought again and again and again until that thought gets into your bone. Once you are impregnated with the thought, you are soaked in the thought, let that thought grip your mind and heart. Not only that, the third point that I want to present in front of you is, once you have a thought, ek baar aapke man mein thought hai, you are soaked in the thought, you should be convicted about the thought. When Mahatma Gandhi decided about a free India, he was convicted that he could really make India free. If Jawaharlal Nehru thought about twist with destiny, definitely Jawaharlal Nehru was convicted in his mind. There would be a day when we are going to make our twist with destiny, our appointment with destiny, our rendezvous with destiny. In the same way, if Martin Luther said, I have a dream, definitely, he was convicted about a dream that there would be a day in America when Negroes would have the same equal rights as the white people have. So conviction is very, very important. Get convicted about what you want to say. One more thing that you need to do is, once you know the purpose that you want to achieve, once you have the thought in your mind, the second thing that you need to do is have a central idea. Have a central idea, a central theme. So the first thing is that central theme should be very clear in our mind. It should be very clear what exactly the central idea is. The central idea must be easily remembered. Whatever the central idea is, people should be able to remember it easily. Someone said like this, kisi ne is prakar se kaha, first impression should be the best impression. And then, once you have convicted people, what you need to do is, you need to conclude in style. Aapko style mein aapko se khatam karna hai. Someone said like this, first impression is the best impression and the last impression should be the lasting impression. Let's come come to the delivery part. Delivery is another important part of communication. The first thing that we need to understand is that there are visual aspects, there are vocal aspects, and there are verbal aspects. Three things are there. Visual, something that you can see. Vocal, something that you speak, how you speak it. And the third thing is verbal, what sentences you use, what type of sentences you use, what words you use, and all those things. These all are part of delivery part, delivery. Now, one thing that we need to understand is, let's learn a little bit about the visual part. In the visual, the most important thing is the physical appearance. Physical appearance. How do you dress up when you go to give a speech? You are asked to give a speech, you are called to give a speech, and you are there to give a speech. The most important thing is your physical, visual aspects and visual aspects. One of the most important things is physical appearance. The second thing that you need to know is the posture. How do you stand in front of people? Do you stand alert and erect without being stiff? You should have a proper eye contact. The fifth one is facial expression. You should have proper facial expression. Now let's come to the vocal aspect. Okay? Now, the other thing that you need to know is your voice inviting? Is it audience friendly? Is it making people, are you able to connect with the people? And do you sound confident? Pace, not only pitch is important, but pace is also important. It contains justified pauses and punches. You know what are punches, you know what are pauses. We have talked about the vocal aspect, we have talked about the appearance, we have talked about the visual aspect, we have talked about the vocal aspect, not only that, last you have the verbal aspect, express things in a few words as possible, use words that audience can understand, use words that sound good together, use strong words to carry the weight of your thoughts, use simile, use metaphors, use rhythm, use alliteration. And not only that, the last thing is if you have any questions.